Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. The group that you see before you are the drums of the Crown Forces 1812. And we represent a typical British infantry fife and drum group from the War of 1812, Napoleonic period. And over the next 10 minutes or so, we'd like to share with you some of the music that might have been heard in the camps before the Siege of Fort Erie in 1814.
Thank you. Thank you.
The original purpose of the drum in the Army was actually not simply to be cadence or to be an accompaniment, musical accompaniment to the fife, but was rather to convey signals. As time evolved, British infantry tactics changed, and the various infantry regiments started to develop systems in which they would be farther spread out than they originally were, and therefore they needed an instrument that would convey the message a little more easily than the drum would. And therefore they started to experiment with the use of the bugle. And during the War of 1812, the Napoleonic period, this was a time when the bugle started to take over communicating signals, especially on the battlefield. And having introduced the bugle as a source of conveying orders, the Army also thought, well, maybe we should develop some marches for that. So we're going to play one of those for you now. Thank you. The marches that the British Army played, or at least the pieces that they played, because they weren't all marches, came from a variety of sources. And often they would come from the country music of the various components of Great Britain. But in addition to that, there were also some classical composers who wrote marches, and we're going to play one of those for you now. It was originally written by George Frederick Handel, and is still the slow march of the Grenadier Guards of Her Majesty's Household Troops. Thank you.
to them. We ask everybody just to observe a bit of silence as we have a performance of a lament out on the battlefield in honor of those who fought and died during this campaign over 200 years ago.